Khabari! Welcome to Sunday Mass with Children!
And happy Good Shepherd Sunday! It's also the fourth Sunday of Easter.
That's right. It's a special Sunday where we get to know Jesus as our shepherd.
We might not think much of a shepherd, but a shepherd is a symbol of protector, power, and authority.
Before we go further, let's start with a prayer so God can bless our time together.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for Good Shepherd Sunday, where you remind us that Jesus is our shepherd, always looking out for us, always protecting us. May we be able to recognize his voice as he calls each of us by our names. Please help us also to have the heart to always want to return to the loving arms of Jesus, our Good Shepherd. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you for sharing your amazing artwork with us week after week on Little Faith Steps. The entries from our local and international friends are colorful and encouraging. We are always inspired by your sharing and beautiful artwork. Keep them coming.
How much do you know about Jesus, our good shepherd?
Play along with this game, and we promise you'll see Jesus in a new light.
Let's go!
Which one of these pictures is of a shepherd? Is it A, B, or C? You got it! A shepherd is someone who takes care of a flock of sheep. Jesus is our shepherd, and we are his sheep.
What makes a good shepherd? Is it A, B, or C? That's right. A good shepherd will do everything to take care of his sheep. He will even risk his life just to find that one lost sheep.
That's how Jesus is with us. If we, as his sheep, are lost, Jesus will do everything to find us, bring us home, and take care of us.
You're doing great so far. Here's the last question. It's a fun one.
How many times are sheep mentioned in the Bible? Easy, right? Is it A, B, or C? Yes, sheep are mentioned more times in the Bible than any other animal. Sheep are a symbol of God's people.
Now that you know, you won't need to go counting in the Bible for sheep.
Hey Jerry, what do you think sheep smell like?
Probably better than fish. Why?
I saw Mom reading a book by the Pope. It was called With the Smell of the Sheep.
Oh yeah, I asked her about it before. It talks about how priests and leaders in the church should be like shepherds who spend so much time with their sheep that they smell like the sheep.
Ooh, that's kind of gross, but also kind of cool.
It's exactly the way Jesus was. He's our God, but he's not like some king sitting on a throne way up high. He came down to be with us, to guide us, and show us an example of how to love.
My sheep know my voice, know my sympathy. My sheep know my voice, my sympathy. They abide in the forest tree, and abide in the forest tree. They love me because they feed my joy.
Jesus called the Good Shepherd. Other than him being near us, I don't see the connection.
Well, it's because of his relationship with each one of us. A Good Shepherd takes care of his sheep and knows each one of them, and he knows when just one of them is lost.
So if I get lost, he would know? How is that possible? There's like a gajillion people in the world.
I think you should know by now that nothing is impossible for God, right? There may be a gajillion people, but he would still do everything to save and protect you when you get lost. That's how deep his love is.
And he remembers me, even among the gajillion people?
Of course. He created you, and after creating you, he has always been with you and always will be, because he's the good shepherd and he will always be with us.
That's comforting. Jerry, guess what I am? Meh, I'm Sheep Joy. Hey, come on, be a good shepherd, Jerry.
In the Bible, sheep were very important to the peoples. The sheep provided food and milk, and they were important to agriculture too. That's how people lived, raising animals and growing vegetables from the earth.
The most important person to take care of the sheep was the shepherd. In the Old Testament, the shepherd was often an image of God. many prophets referred to God as the shepherd of the people of Israel.
Jesus says he is our shepherd too. He lays down his life for his sheep, us. He's not someone the farmer has hired. We, the sheep, are his very own. If a wolf comes to attack the sheep, Jesus will defend and even give up his life for his sheep.
Which he did, remember? On Good Friday, Jesus sacrificed himself on the cross for our sins. And we have Easter because he rose from the dead. Even in this way, Jesus would never abandon his sheep.
Amen. Oh, hey, Jeanette. I've got a joke. What's a religious sheep called? A Baptist.
Have you heard of the one called Savior? Have you heard of his perfect love? Have you heard of the one in heaven? Have you heard how he gave his son? 'Cause I have found his love. I believe in the Son. Show me your one called Savior. I believe he's the risen one. I believe that I'll live forever. I believe that my King will come. 'Cause I have found his love. I believe in the Son. Show me your way. Jesus, you are my best friend. And you'll always be. Nothing will ever change that. Jesus, you are my best friend. And you'll always
St. John Bosco, the founder of the Salesians, was born in Italy in 1815. His mother, Margherita Occhiena, raised him and his two brothers after his father died. Although they were poor, they always found something to share with homeless who knocked on their door. At 9 years old, St. John Bosco had a dream where the Virgin Mary called him to educate young people, so he started preaching to other children even as a boy. When St. John Bosco became a priest, he energetically worked for prisoners, youth, and street children. He opened the Society of St. Francis de Sales, where they could study Christian life, learn trades, and find jobs. The society still exists today and even continues to help people around the world, especially children. St. John Bosco also held workshops for shoemaking, tailoring, and printing. He was so convinced of the power of mass media that he spent half his nights writing books and magazines. His motto was, "Give me the souls and keep the rest." Do you know the secret to St. John Bosco's boundless energy? He said it was his constant union with God and his confidence in Mother Mary. St. John Bosco educated the whole person, the body and the soul. He believed we should always seek Jesus in everything and that we should let Jesus' love flow through everything we do, whether we are studying, working, or playing.
It is now time to set up your altar table and prepare for Holy Mass. Take a moment now to get these items and see you in a while.
Hey, don't forget to take a photo and post it on Facebook or Instagram or any social media with the hashtag CatholicMassAtHome.
Let us now listen to what Auntie Estella has to share with us in one Mass minute.
The altar at Mass is covered in a pure white cloth, like a table set for a fine meal. This reminds us of the Last Supper, where Jesus first gave himself to us in the form of bread and wine. Have you noticed that during the offertory hymn, Father gets ready to consecrate the bread and wine by taking out two more pieces of white cloth? The first piece he unfolds is called the corporal. This big square cloth is placed under the paten to catch any crumbs which might fall from the host. The second piece is a rectangle called the purificator. Father uses this to wipe any drips or spills from the chalice. But why are the contents of the paten and chalice so important? We remember that Jesus said, "This is my body. This is my blood." Every particle or drop is Jesus, whole and entire. When Jesus multiplied the loaves and fish to feed the 5,000, he told his friends to gather up the fragments so that nothing would be lost. If plain bread was so precious, shouldn't we treat the bread of life with even more care?
Thank you, Auntie Estella. Let us now settle down. Sit in front of your altar table, take a moment to be silent and prepare for Holy Mass.
Wishing all mothers a happy and blessed Mother's Day. With gratitude, we give thanks and appreciate all mothers who have shown love and compassion to us children. For each and every mother, you are special and loved. May God give you strength and hope when you get discouraged, and that His blessings and graces be upon you on this special day where we celebrate the gift of you. Welcome, my brothers and sisters in Christ, to the Holy Mass with children. Thank you for joining us to sing songs of praise and learn more about Jesus as the Good Shepherd. There's nothing like giving God our hearts and our voices to worship Him as our loving Father. Let us now worship the Lord together on Good Shepherd Sunday, 8 May 2022. We offer up this Mass for young people discerning their vocations, that Christ, our Good Shepherd, may guide them on their way. Join us in singing the processional hymn.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
So my dear brothers and sisters, today we celebrate the fourth Sunday of Easter. But today there are also two things that we celebrate. We celebrate first Good Shepherd Sunday. We celebrate Jesus, the Good Shepherd. And we celebrate also Vocation Sunday. Some of you may be wondering, What is this Vocation Sunday? Is it the same as vacation? No, it's not. But I will explain it a bit more in my homily later. So as we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us now acknowledge our sins.
I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God,
pray. Almighty ever-living God, lead us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul and Barnabas carried on from Perga till they reached Antioch in Pisidia. Here they went to synagogue on the Sabbath and took their seats. When the meeting broke up, many Jews and devout converts joined Paul and Barnabas.
and in their talks with them, Paul and Barnabas urged them to remain faithful to the grace God had given them. The next Sabbath, almost the whole town assembled to hear the word of God. When they saw the crowds, the Jews, prompted by jealousy, used blasphemies and contradicted everything Paul said. Then Paul and Barnabas spoke out boldly. "We had to proclaim the word of God to you first, but since you have rejected it, since you do not think yourselves worthy of eternal life, you must turn to the pagans. For this is what the Lord commanded us to do when he said, 'I have made you a light for nations, so that my salvation may reach the ends of the earth.'" It made the pagans very happy to hear this, and they thanked the Lord for his message. All who were destined for eternal life became believers. Thus, the word of the Lord spread through the whole countryside. But the Jews worked upon some of the devout women of the upper classes and the leading men of the city, and persuaded them to turn against Paul and Barnabas and expel them from their territory. So they shook the dust from their feet in defiance and went off to Iconium. But the disciples were filled with joy and the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response is, "We are his people, the sheep of his flock. Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him singing for joy." Response: "We are his people, the sheep of his flock. Know that he, the Lord, is God. He made us. We belong to him. We are his people, the sheep of his flock." Response: "We are his people, the sheep of his flock. Indeed, how good is the Lord. Eternal his merciful love. He is faithful from age to age." Response: "We are his people, the sheep of his flock."
A reading from the book of the Apocalypse. I, John, saw a huge number, impossible to count, of people from every nation, race, tribe, and language. They were standing in front of the throne and in front of the Lamb, dressed in white robes and holding palms in their hands. One of the elders said, "These are the people who have been through the great persecution, and because they have washed their robes white again in the blood of the Lamb, they now stand in front of God's throne and serve him day and night in his sanctuary. And the one who sits on the throne will spread his tent over them. They will never hunger or thirst again. Neither the sun nor the scorching wind will ever plague them, because the Lamb who is at the throne will be their shepherd and will lead them to springs of living water, and God will wipe away all tears from their eyes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, "The sheep that belong to me listen to my voice. I know them and they follow me. I give them eternal life. They will never be lost, and no one will ever steal them from me. The Father who gave them to me is greater than anyone, and no one can steal from the Father. The Father and I are one." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So, my dear young friends, at the beginning of Mass, I mentioned today we celebrate the fourth Sunday of Easter. But there are also two other things that we celebrate today. The first is Good Shepherd Sunday. And then the second thing that we celebrate is actually related to Good Shepherd Sunday, is Vocation Sunday. So what is Vocation Sunday? You know, many of us may be young, but we may have something in our mind. You know, I'm sure people have asked you, what do you want to be when you grow up? So some of us want to be fireman, policeman, teacher, doctor, lawyer. I don't know whether anybody wants to be a priest or to be a religious brother or sister. I hope that is one of your things that you want to be when you grow up, you know. But this is very much what we call ambition, what I want. Vocation, or Christian vocation, is a bit different. It is very much what God feels is the best for me. Because God knows what will make us joyful. You know, of course, we may have many things that we can do that will also give us joy, but God knows what is the best way to help us to be joyful, and the best path for us to be holy. And what we want, if it can match with what God wants for us, you know, if these two can match, then of course that is the most ideal. But then again, to put it in simple terms, how do I know? Maybe one thing that you can start asking yourself is this: what do I want to be when I grow up? You know, and will this person that I want to be able, you know, two things just to remember. First thing is to use the talents that God has given to me. Okay? And number two is that, will this help to make God pleased with me? Christian vocation very basically is just about these two things. Okay? If God has given you the gift of painting and all that, then maybe you want to use your gift as a painter or something greater. Maybe you won't end up as a painter, you know, but maybe in the art circle where you can use it to give glory to God. Maybe if God has given you the great gift, you know, of being very good in mathematics, something for you to think about, to be a mathematician or to be a teacher, to help others to be as good as you in mathematics. So that is Christian vocation. And today we also celebrate Good Shepherd Sunday. And of course, one of the vocation is the priesthood. No? And also we see Jesus as the Good Shepherd, the one that is leading us. And also as a priest, I'm also called to be a shepherd, to really be like Jesus, to lead all of you to Jesus. But Good Shepherd Sunday, very often when we think about Good Shepherd Sunday, we think, oh, Jesus will lead us, Jesus will lead us, you know. Jesus will help us, Jesus will protect us. But we forget one very important point. Today in the Gospel of John, Jesus says, "The sheep that belong to me listen to my voice. I know them and they follow me." That is what Jesus says, you know. So, we are all the sheep of Jesus and we must learn to listen to His voice. How do we do that? You know, first question, do we pray every day? And in our prayer, do we spend maybe 3 minutes, 5 minutes just to keep quiet and say, "Jesus, you know, I'm going to keep quiet, I'm going to listen to you. And then we keep quiet and ask Jesus to give us the peace in our hearts so that we can hear Jesus' voice. And then we can also hear what He wants to ask of us. That is one thing. The next thing is following Jesus. Jesus is the good shepherd who leads us and protects us. Will we follow Jesus? That is the most important question that we have to answer today. Because if we don't answer this question, okay, then Jesus as the good shepherd will not make sense to us. And then our Christian vocation will also not make sense to us. Because we must follow Jesus. And one way to follow Jesus, of course, is to pray and then to listen to the voice of Jesus to tell us what He wants us to do. But another way to follow Jesus is also to follow those who are taking care of us. Our parents, you know, very often they tell you, hey, don't watch so much TV. Hey, don't play so much computer games. It's time to study. It's time to eat your lunch. It's time to go to bed. You know, these are things that our parents do for us because they love us. They care for us. And so they are also like our shepherds. You know, one way to learn how to follow Jesus, to be obedient to Jesus, is also to be obedient to our parents. Maybe in school, to be obedient to your teachers. When they leave you for 5 minutes and ask you to do your work, what do you do? Do you chit-chat with your classmates? Or do you try your best to be conscientious and do the work that your teacher asks you to do? Yeah, that is one way. Are we obedient to the people who are older than us when they help us and they help us to become better? That is also one way to be obedient to Jesus, you know? So my dear friends, like I mentioned, today we celebrate Vocation Sunday and Good Shepherd Sunday. You know, Jesus is the Good Shepherd, always wanting the best for us. And of course, He wants the best for us in our future as well. So I want to invite you, first of course, to have your ambition, what you want to be when you grow up, so that you can use it to praise and glorify God. But important also, continue to pray and keep quiet time, and ask Jesus to tell you what is the best way for you to be joyful and to be a holy person. Okay? So today at this Mass, we pray for these two things. And let us continue this Eucharistic celebration to give thanks to Jesus for being our Good Shepherd. And so let us take the Creed.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day. In accordance with the Scriptures, He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
And now we will have the prayer of the faithful. Loving Father, You gave us Jesus to be our Good Shepherd. With confidence in the intercession of the Good Shepherd, we turn to God, our loving Father, for what we need. So hear us, Father, as we bring You our prayers, for others and for ourselves.
The response is, "Shepherd your flock, O Lord." For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, Archbishop William Goh, all priests and clergy, we pray the Lord grant them, as shepherds of the Church, the strength and courage in their care and leadership as they lead Christ's flock in the ways of faith, hope, and love. We pray to the Lord, "Shepherd your flock, O Lord." We pray for active participation and the grace of openness towards one another, so that the synodal process, as initiated by Pope Francis, may renew our commitment to walk with one another towards the vision of God for His Church in Singapore. We pray to the Lord, "Shepherd your flock, O Lord." For leaders of every nation, we pray that the Good Shepherd will guide the leaders of governments as they work to protect the lives and dignity of their people. We pray to the Lord, "Shepherd your flock, O Lord." For the Church, we pray that we may be united in truth and love as one flock under one Good Shepherd. We pray to the Lord, "Shepherd your flock, O Lord." For this world of day of prayer for vocations, we pray that God would grant the gift of courage to more young people and that they will be open to hear the call of the Good Shepherd and follow Him, laying down their lives in love and service of God and neighbor. We pray to the Lord, "Shepherd your flock, O Lord." For all mothers on this Mother's Day weekend, we pray that God will continue to bless these women who have sacrificed much and given of themselves as they taught, comforted, and cared for children, both their own and others. We pray to the Lord, "Shepherd your flock, O Lord." For the world, we pray that the presence of Jesus, the Good Shepherd, may bring healing, peace, and joy to all in need. We pray to the Lord, "Shepherd your flock, O Lord." For those who have died, we pray that they may be led with joy to pastures of everlasting life, into the presence of our Good Shepherd. We pray to the Lord, "Shepherd your flock, O Lord." Let us take a moment for our personal intentions and the intentions of our family and friends who have asked for our prayers. We pray to the Lord, "Shepherd your flock, O Lord."
God of love, you care for your flock across every desert and through every dark place. You know us each by name. Seek out and restore all those who have lost their ways, that they may come together into the glory of your kingdom. Help us to hear the call of our Good Shepherd and to follow him with faith and love. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Good Shepherd, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. And do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, William our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father.
Our Father,
who art in
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. So, my dear friends, this is Jesus, the Good Shepherd. Jesus who loves us, who wants the best for us, who wants us to live a holy life. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
So, my dear young friends, although we may not be able to go to church this weekend to participate in the Eucharist, but I invite you to just keep your hearts focused on Jesus, say a prayer so that we are all in spiritual communion, because we are all one church, one body.
We invite all those watching to make an act of spiritual communion with a spirit of gratefulness, thanking God for His infinite love and sacrifice. With humble and contrite hearts, let us express our desire to invite Jesus into our souls. My Jesus, I believe that You are present in the most holy sacrament. I love You above all things, and I desire to receive You into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive You sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace You as if You were already there and unite myself wholly to You. Never permit me to be separated from You. Amen.
Let us pray. Look upon Your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pastures the sheep You have redeemed. By the precious blood of Your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God continue to bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.